What's popping, people? Welcome back to your friendly hood.
Last Saturday on this channel, I released a video talking about the Supreme Court overturning Roe v. Wade. For any of you that might have been living under a rock at the time that this happened and you just did not hear about this at all, for the past almost 50 years, a Supreme Court decision has been in place that has essentially made it illegal to ban abortion. This decision was called Roe v. Wade. It basically banned states from banning abortion. You could make regulations on like when the abortion was allowed to take place. However, you could not outright ban it. Last Friday on June 24th, the Supreme Court overturned a decision, giving us the opportunity to finally ban the murder of children. Now, obviously, based on the way I just described abortion, you understand my position on abortion. Now, I am a Christian, and from my point of view, abortion is evil. It is the murder of children. And I could show you a plethora of ghastly images. I'm gonna spare you of that. If you want to see why abortion is evil, watch this video. It'll explain it pretty clearly. However, I would like to say to all the Satanists that try to claim the Bible does not talk about abortion in a negative way, right here, this is Exodus 21 verse 22. If men strive and hurt a woman with child so that her fruit depart from her, and yet no injury followed, he shall surely be punished according as to what the woman's husband will lay upon him. And he shall pay as the judges determine. And if any mischief follow, then you shall give life for life, eye for eye, tooth for tooth, hand for hand, foot for foot, burning for burning, wound for wound, stripe for stripe. So I'm just saying the Bible literally says abortion is bad. It doesn't just say thou shall not murder. Although people should know from the fact that it says thou shall not murder that abortion is bad. But just in case people were convinced that there was some kind of gray area with the fetus in the womb, the Bible is very clear that that is evil. So this isn't what the topic of the video is, but you cannot be a Christian that is walking in the spirit, walking with God, that believes abortion is okay. If you're a new Christian, if you're maybe just got saved like a year ago or sooner, I can cut you a little bit of slack. You don't know everything. I don't know everything. But if after hearing that, you cannot equivocally say with 100% certainty that abortion is evil, you are probably not saved, because you probably do not actually believe that what God says is true. And if you don't believe that's true, I don't see how you can believe that Jesus rising from the dead, paying for your sins, is true. But anyways, on that video that I made last Saturday, I got a comment from someone who was pro the murder of children. The comment read as followed: not sure how it ended up on this video, but since I'm here, why must everyone else have to follow the same views as you, or you immediately demonize them, saying things like the Antichrist? It's the 21st century, and I think everyone can get along doing what they please with their own bodies without someone else feeling the need to control them, no matter what your God says in the Bible. And so I'm making this video in response to this comment, because this worldview is a very prevalent one, even among Christians. Although Christians might not use it to justify abortions, I know that a lot of Christians would in some ways agree with the statement that this commenter just made. So what this comment basically boils down to, the fundamental belief driving his argument here, is that people can still get along even if they have totally different worldviews, totally different ways of understanding the world, that people can still get along. But is that really a true statement, right? Can people actually get along when they're being allowed to do whatever they want with their bodies? See, we look in the modern world, and in the modern world, we essentially have this reality already. If not today, being that abortion was banned just a couple days ago, we certainly had it just a month ago. We basically live in a world where all standards of morality are abolished. People can basically do or say whatever they want, the only standard being as long as it does not hurt other people. Most of the things that used to be considered evil and unthinkable, such as being a cross-dresser, cutting off your penis because you like cross-dressing so much, putting phallic objects up your butt, being addicted to drugs, being addicted to alcohol, being addicted to pornography, all these things which at one point were unthinkable, totally ostracized out of society, have become totally normal. There is no real standard for humans anymore, at least in the West. Has our society become more happy? Answer is no. People are more unhappy than they have ever been throughout all of human history. People are isolated. People are not getting along. People are trying to distance themselves as much as they can from other people. They don't know their neighbors. They don't know the people in their community. There's more division more than ever. There's more racial animosity. Men and women hate each other. It's literally what the whole feminist movement, liberating women, is about. It's literally just about women hating men, refusing to work together and love each other. They need to compete with each other. Women need to compete with men, and men need to compete with women instead of coming together as a unit and working together. That's something that seems impossible. Everyone is now an individual. Nobody is a part of a group. Nobody is a part of a collective. Everyone is an individual, atomized person that has no connections to anyone else. The only relationships they have is through a phone screen or a computer monitor. You go to a public school and you'll find people in middle school, maybe even younger, that are already having suicidal thoughts. In fact, that is the norm for middle schoolers to be having suicidal thoughts and cutting themselves. Are we really living in a happy society right here? And people might say that this is the result of hateful bigots such as myself, but if you really do your research, you realize that that is simply not the case. People who have beliefs not even a fraction as extreme as I do are totally ostracized from society. They are isolated even more than normal people are isolated, and they're already pretty isolated. People are banned from banks for questioning the current narrative upon which we construct our world. They're banned from getting a job, from participating in society. They can't even have a Twitter account. They can't even use YouTube. And then these people will be investigated as domestic terrorists. So if the problem is not coming from opposition to the freedom, to letting people do what they want, then these problems must be stemming from the freedom itself. That when people are allowed to live in total immorality, total degeneracy, constantly committing the things that the Bible says you shouldn't commit, people are brought into despair. It destroys people. People that allow themselves to fall into this total degeneracy that is allegedly supposed to be liberating them, you find that all you've been liberated to do is to put a chain around your neck. These people are theoretically free to do anything, but through giving people this freedom, we've created a society that basically lacks any of the benefits of freedom. There's no point. See, these people care so much about rights. They care so much about freedom. But yet these people don't believe in the freedom to be born. You don't have the right to be born in America. You don't have the right to have parents that love you. You don't have the right to have a community that actually takes care of each other. You don't have the right to grow up as the gender you were born as. You don't have the right to not be molested by someone. You don't have the right to not have your innocence stripped away from you by sexualized media and people marching around the street in quote-unquote pride parades wearing BDSM gear. We have all this freedom, allegedly, but yet we lack the freedom that actually matters. The whole society we've created based on these liberal libertarian ideals is literally living hell, but yet people still want to defend it. Let's get out of all of our book cucking, let's get away from all of our philosophy, and let's look objectively at reality. Let us be realists for a second. Let us be real. No cap, buck 50. What fruits have the libertarian ideals produced? Suffering. Unimaginable suffering. The invention of new ways to make people suffer. Man-made horrors beyond our comprehension. Why do we still defend this idea? What, because philosophically, like, it would be bad to force people to do something? Is that a good enough justification to turn the world into living hell? Are you really willing to make that bargain that, like, I don't want to force people to do anything against their will, so therefore I'm going to allow the world to become living hell? I don't think that's a worthwhile bargain. Don't we have a higher standard? Instead of just picking this mediocre thing to aim our society at, why can't we aim for excellency? Why can't I aim for wanting to make society better? Why can't people do the right thing? Why can't we strive to make a world where people have the right to be born? People have the right to a loving family. Why can't people have the right to grow up as the gender they were born as? Why can't people have the right to have a community that cares for them? Why can't we make a society like that? It's not impossible. We used to have a society like that 80 years ago. Why can't we have a society where people can have 7 kids and not have to live in utter poverty? Why is it that both of the parents have to work and the kids have to be sent to some daycare being raised by people that aren't their flesh and blood, right? Why can't we have a society where the dad can support the family on one income? Why is that so evil? Why is that such an evil thing to want people to be happy? You don't think people should have the right to choose to live in total despair and total depression and kill themselves? Think about slashing a razor through their wrist every single day? No, I don't think people should have the right to do that. Why would I want to create a society where people consider slashing a razor blade through their wrist every single day of their life? Why do you want to create a society where that's even a thinkable option? This is what our movement's about. Now, it says in the Bible, God is love. And fundamentally, what our movement, America First, Christian nationalism, radical Christianity, our movement is seeking love. A society where people love one another, where people support one another, where people can find true happiness and true fulfillment. And people say this is a utopian ideal, therefore we can't strive for it because utopia is impossible. But when I look at the happiest people in society, the people who are least depressed, they're people like me. They are people who are Christians. They are people who are conservative. They're people who are not participating in this satanic world order. And beyond that, the fact is that there is a God. The fact also is that the God that designed all this is my God. The Christian God is the only God. It's been proven true because his son, his messenger, Jesus Christ, rose from the dead and prove that what he said is true and that our God is the God. And since we know that there is a God, and that God's all-powerful, all-knowing, and that God is my God, it is the Christian God, then what he says must be true. And what God says is that when we follow him, when we stay away from the unnatural sins that bring us despair, we turn and we start walking with him, that is when you will find true fulfillment, true happiness. It says that when we follow him, we are fulfilling the purpose which we were designed for. And if all that is true, then if we really made a society based around following God, we would create something approximating a utopia. Now, I don't think we'll ever create a utopia, not on this earth. We have to wait for Jesus's return. We still have the issue of sin. The devil still is the ruler of this earth, whether or not we like it or not. But what I am saying is that we have the ability to make the world much better than it is now. And if we can make the world better than it is right now, if we can lift people out of the suffering, despair that their daily lives are, then I see no reason why we should not strive for that. So that's all. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. I wanna turn the whole thing upside down. I'll find the things they say just can't be found. I'll share this love I find with everyone. We'll sing and dance to Mother Nature's songs. I don't want this feeling to go away.